streaming? You're streaming. Hello, everybody, in case you can hear through the mic. Do you want to introduce yourself?
Hi, I'm Sweet.
You don't need to wave, because we don't have video on.
I know, but I always wave. It's a thing I do.
It's fine. We are playing through my game, Manna for Malices, which Sweet has never played, and she is, I think, probably never played a VM.
I have not.
I'm going to walk you through the stuff you need to know.
Fantastic.
Volume is on your thing, because you're probably going to want to drop it down. I do get a certain amount of feedback on the game. The feedback that I get is people say the music fits the story well, but it's too loud. And people say the art sucks, and people say the writing's good. And guess which of the things I did myself and which I paid for somebody to do.
I know this already.
Yes. Okay, so I'm going to show... So this is not a general VM feature, but I implemented this. So, notes. These, as you play the game, if you're within a save, these get filled out with more details.
Nice.
Okay. And then within about, I have the characters, all these characters as you know them at the beginning of the game, plus, like, a whole bunch of, like, a little encyclopedia about stuff in Japanese culture, stuff in occult stuff. So, you know, what's the cultural import of American military bases in Japan? what does Aniki mean? As these come up, if you don't understand something, or you think that something has more detail than you're getting, let me know and I can explain something. But it's generally, for anybody playing at home, this has lots of details, including, you know, if you are confused about the puzzles depend on magic, and there's a little kind of intro to chaos magic within this encyclopedia. So, yes, I'm going to start. Let me begin with a little movie that I made. Only plays on the start of the first time. I was proud of that because I did all the animation myself. Okay, so you see that there are things on the bottom of the screen. You don't need to click any of those yet. Some of them are not highlighted, but you will have an auto button as well. Generally speaking, you click to advance. So click anywhere. And, yeah. So you see the auto button down there? That will automatically go forward. You won't have to click to go forward. I recommend that along with the later on you're going to want to use the skip button. say that in this game, the characters are a little bit meaner to each other than I will be making them in later games. I'm relying on that meanness for humor, unfortunately. And so the things that Kuroneko says about Chironeko are not things that I believe to be actually true. I think she's just being mean. If you need to pause the auto, by the way, you just click and it'll go back to manual clicking.
Ellie's pathologically needy, in case you haven't noticed. I think I mentioned this before, but on the first loop you don't have any choices, and then it's with the second loop that you start having choices. So that's about as graphic as this game gets. You don't need to save at this point. She's very sweary, but you're not supposed to read her as like angry, just very sweary. So you see the skip button? That's going to skip you to the next choice. It's going to fast forward to the next choice. If you need to back up when you reach there, you can use the scroll wheel and scroll up, and it'll scroll you back a couple dialogue options. Also, if some dialogue changes, it'll skip you to that point, if that's earlier. So once you have a sense for the core loop, it makes sense to use skip. Gonna smoke. Do you want any? looking okay thus far? If the class is still entertaining, you can rewatch it. It's up to you.
Woo!
Okay, so if you want to get the context, you can scroll up. Scroll wheel?
Up where?
So, scroll wheel? See
the
scroll wheel?
Oh. Yeah,
scroll.
Oh, got it, sorry.
It's early, so it doesn't, your choice doesn't matter too much, but it does give you all the options.
Library.
Mm-hmm.
Like you knew I would do library, right?
Library is a very useful place to have lunch. I'll say that. I did say it was useful.
Uh-huh.
I think I literally have that book.
So later on in the game, you'll be able to go to her and get help with stuff. You don't need to save this one. Really, only once you see the altar does it start to make sense to save. Yeah. Just got an achievement. You don't need to save yet.
thing, by the way. That's a real patch, too. She's getting her own game eventually, by the way. Yes. You brought yours in? Give me your keys. Oh, they're probably on the table. Okay.
Thank you.
don't see your circle.
I forgot it.
Thoughts, yes. Yes, okay.
Secret thoughts.
So, as you saw with revisiting the military installation, sometimes the second time you do something, the second time you experience something, you notice more, and that opens up new possibilities. Sometimes it opens up new options in that area, but sometimes it opens up new options elsewhere. just saw some symbols. You can do it the next time you live. Life is cheap in this game. So you're acting in the spirit of exploration of the game, but I can't tell you which paths are like finished for now, if you want. Up to you. Now you know that he's there and that he has a gun. You don't know it yet, but now you know that there has to be one. So put type something in and hit enter. Enter. But you know who to ask. It's unique for every playthrough. Use the, I don't have that more. Enter. No, you don't need to save yet. You know she's there now.
before I did this one.
Mm-hmm. You can scroll back before a choice if you need to. What are you thinking? You want a hint? Okay, so there's an option at Shironeko about the OSS that you haven't chosen. I think you should ask her about the OSS, and then you should come back onto the roof and do the Masonic initiation thing. And there's going to be something that opens up. I believe that's all. Those two are the only things you have to do. Do you know why?
Who do I ask?
Shironeko, the hacker. You ask her about the OSS, which is the Masonic Lodge that they have. So, at this point, I think you have to go back to Mimi in the morning to get info. So I think that's the trigger for it. Well, maybe not. Okay. So I guess you're just gonna have to go on to the roof. A new option. Do you see it? Yeah. Okay. And this is the point at which there is a bad option. Can you imagine what the bad option is? No, that is a good option. Yeah, that would be the one that you do not want to choose.
So tempting.
Yeah, don't do that one. But picking up the knife is good. Inverting the Janus head will unlock the other side of the thing. It'll unlock another day. So the logic of this is the main puzzle. So I want you to tell me what you think the logic of this puzzle is. Okay, what is Janus the god of?
Oh no, he has the mm-hmm. Yeah.
What month is named after Janus? January. Yeah, okay. So he is the god of thresholds, but also specifically of thresholds in time, which is why one head is old and one head is young. And now that circle has two astrological symbols on it. One corresponds to a specific time during the fall and the other during the spring. In other words, Halloween, May Day. And then you have a knife. And your main character got stabbed with a knife and is now unstuck in time. Sure.
Yeah.
Return is down. Look down. Return. Now if you go up on the roof. Do not invert the head or destroy the altar. Just click never mind here. You'd like that.
Huh.
I will tell you, you do not need to try to sneak out.
Yeah, I didn't think so, but like, it's, you know.
Yes, for some of them I closed it out aggressively, and then for this one I didn't, because there are, you could visit other options, even though you chose the best one at that point. But it was.
She stabbed me. I want to stab her.
Mm-hmm.
She stabbed me twice. I want to stab.
You gotta.
I know. Just give me a second.
Thank you. that's Japanese BDSM terminology, M for masochist, which they just generally use for sub in general. So who do you think you're going to transmigrate? Oh. I guess there you go. You're good. You're getting pretty close to the end of the game, by the way. Never mind. No, you don't want. All three people that need to be transmigrated are transmigrated. Don't yet. So there's. So you just need to get to Halloween to do something at the Halloween party before you disrupt the ritual. Or else you get one of the bad ends. In fact, if you save here, we can go back and show you the bad end if you want. After you've gotten the good one. missing. There should be a third option, I think, that shows up. Maybe there's something. Okay, so maybe I'm forgetting some condition that we have to handle. So I think you've already gotten all of those.
I know, I'm just...
Yeah.
A new one show up, so I'm just seeing.
Yeah.
It's like maybe something showed up.
Yep. I'm trying to remember. What is that... Maybe it's under your right. There we go. This is the new scene. You didn't want to see the bad end if you didn't do that.
Oh, sorry.
It's no big deal. It's just that when you get to the ending instead of the good last scene, you have a bad last scene where they go to visit Shironeko and she's been killed by Yakuza. It's not a big deal. Now we get to disrupt the ritual when that outfit shows up. you don't need to go to the thing yet. It's fine. Don't worry about it. Just don't destroy the altar here, because you'll get. Yeah, you gotta be patient on that. It's like Japanese bar food. It's considered sort of old man food. Wait. 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 Think. Basically going to be in a loop until you choose the correct order of magic clones and aliens. So I actually don't remember what the order is supposed to be.